Hi, my name is Steven Trellis. I am 21 years old and I am an agnostic. Prayer to me is just a diary mentally. I understand religion's use of it. It's used as a connection between the person and their deity. And that's with all due respect, but personally I see it as it was a way of basically writing down in your diary every night to make sense of what happened in the world, what happened to you, what happened to your family. Not only that, but typically when people pray, they just ask for some kind of divine intervention, but they also work toward fixing it themselves. But whenever they end up fixing it themselves, then they say, oh, that was the divine intervention. But if nothing happens, then they just say, oh, that was just God's will. So that's how I see prayer.
Does prayer affect your daily life?
Prayer doesn't really affect me. It affects my friends. I know that they go off and pray. I have friends who are Christian. I have friends who are atheists. I have friends who are Muslim. Other than that, it doesn't really affect me at all.
How would you explain it to someone else?
Basically how I explained it is basically it's a way of keeping track of your thoughts and of what's happened and ways to fix them. I think it's initially a cry out. It's cathartic. It helps you release some emotion. And then once you get that emotion out of the way, you can start focusing on the logical side of things and try and solve your problems. Again, I see the need for it as far as religion itself. But other than that, I don't see any actual, like divine intervention from it.
Okay, so you just see the how it benefits perception, but mm-hmm. of a person's life, but not the actual intervention.
I don't think there's anything supernatural that comes from it.
Okay.
At least from my experience. I could be wrong, and I'm more than happy to be proven wrong or to be proven right, but I would much rather be proven wrong because I want to see people be helped, but I also want to see people help themselves, so I see the need for people not to depend on prayer, because mm-hmm. what if they are wrong?
Right.
You know, they need to help themselves. I've seen the case of many people who they rely on prayer, and now their lives are, they're just not in good shape, because they've relied heavily on that and haven't even addressed anything themselves.
Okay. So, how has prayer been altered throughout your life as far as your perception of what prayer is? How has it evolved?
It evolves from me being a kid and asking God for certain toys, and stuff like that, to me growing older and having a lot more responsibilities. Like when I was an early teenager, if I can have, not be bullied, can we not be put in this financial hardship? Can we not have all these issues? Can you please fix this? Can you please fix world hunger? Can you please fix all these issues wrong with the world? And nothing was met. It's not that I'm mad, it's just I just didn't see any results. And in the scientific term, if your experiment failed, well, it failed. That means it doesn't work. But I went from that to seeing the need for it in certain cultures because I think it offers hope. And that's what a lot of people need to keep going is hope. But once you get that understanding, it's just, I just don't see the need for it anymore. And I felt that way for the past few years. But then I have an open mind on everything. I'm more than happy to be proven wrong. And I just want people to understand that things go past what they normally see. And that goes for me, for you, and everyone else.
Henley, what is prayer? What does prayer mean to you?
It means talking to Jesus.
To Jesus? And how does prayer affect you? What happens when you pray?
I don't know.
You don't know? That's okay. Why do you think people pray?
To tell Jesus how their day was.
To tell Jesus how their day was?
Hi, my name is Nawar Rabiawi. I am a student here at OU, and I am a Muslim. I believe that there's only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that the Prophet Muhammad was the last prophet that he sent, and that Ali is his cousin and the one after him. I am what they call a Shia Muslim. I am 25. Prayer to me is my way of communicating with God, my way of talking to Him, telling Him about my problems, what I go through on a day-to-day basis. I pray five times a day, and I do pray five times a day, every day, and it means a lot to me. I mean, it's kind of what keeps that relation between me and God, you know, strong. I mean, I'm a little superstitious. I can't prove that prayer really does affect my day-to-day life, but I do feel better when I pray. And a lot of times where I've been in a whole lot of trouble, in which I prayed about it, and I was out of that trouble. Well, actually, I shouldn't say all I did was pray. No, I did take, you know, actions to get myself out of trouble, and I did get myself out of trouble. But I do feel like the more I pray, the better my life gets in multiple variety of ways, being doing a better job at work, getting, you know, understanding schoolwork better and getting better grades. And generally speaking, prayer keeps me happy and makes my life better. Well, in Islam, you have to pray five times a day. I mean, it's not—it's kind of a mandatory thing to do. So it's important in a sense because it's mandatory. It's an essential part of the religion. If you really can't call yourself a Muslim if you don't pray five times a day. And at the same time, it's a fundamental part of the religion because if you don't, you know, praying in Islam is a way for you to. It when you pray, you recite certain Quranic verses, and you speak to God directly. And without prayer, there's really not a whole lot of other ways in Islam in which you can communicate with God. And so, if you don't pray, there's almost no communication between you and God. If there's no communication between you and God, do you even believe in that religion? And so, in a sense, prayer is what Islam is founded upon. You have to pray. It's a mandatory thing to do.
How would you go about explaining to someone who is not religious at all? How would you explain prayer to them if they don't know what prayer is?
For someone that's not very religious, there's two ways you can view prayer. You can view it something you need, like a bucket list. You need to do it. In order for you to accomplish this, you have to do it. In order for you to be a Muslim, and I guess you can say enter heaven, as that's what most Muslims and most religious people want to do, you have to pray. So something you just do. But for somebody that's not religious, that individual is most likely does not value religious practices and does not value religious beliefs, and therefore doesn't think that they should be applied. I would approach it by saying, look, for us, prayer isn't something that we do just because we follow that religion. It isn't something I do just because I'm Muslim. It's something I do because it's a way I can communicate with God. It's a relationship that I want to maintain in my life, and that relationship is, you know, as most relationships are, they're built on communication. And without communication, you really don't have a relationship at all. And so prayer for me is just a way for me to kind of vent and talk to God about my problems, about what I need, and just my day-to-day life.
My name is Marcelo Perez. I'm from Fort Worth, Texas. I was baptized as Catholic. Prayer means to me, I feel like it's a formal way of communicating with God.
Okay, nice.
It affects my daily life just because there's only so much you can confess in like confessions and stuff like that. And like by talking to God, it's like a personal way of communicating with Him and expressing how I feel on a daily. Well, being Catholic, Catholics are very formal, so our way of communicating with God is very important in that sense. So it's very formal. We keep it old school.
To invoke a higher in any way of power represents some kind of prayer. There are different kinds of prayer, such as invocation, confession, praise, thanksgiving, lamentation, and petition. Most people believe that by praying to a higher power, their wish will be granted, or they will form a deeper connection with God because they are showing gratitude or praise for what He has given them in life. We believe that by praying to God, our problems will be solved over time, and if they are not solved, then we assume that things happened as they should. People pray sometimes to bring peace into their life in the midst of a calm. A few religions bring meditation into their spiritual practice and focus their energy and thoughts on themselves, while others primarily focus this time on praying to the higher power. Prayer can bring comfort into one's life because they feel that God is fixing all their problems, and it is an easy outlet for them to bring their worries to. People also pray to God, thanking Him for all they have been blessed with, and as a result, they feel better knowing that they have acknowledged and showed gratitude for their blessings. Whether someone is praying to a higher power for help, confessing their sin, or showing gratitude, it promotes peace and positivity in the world. Psychologically, these conversations with the Lord or with a higher power allow us to feel spiritually connected and overall protected by something bigger than ourselves. The everyday worries that one experiences become smaller, and the fear that occurs regarding death and the impending future can be relieved when we process the grander abilities of an all-knowing power in the universe.